Hi, this is Purnima Devi SK, lecturer in mathematics, Abhinav Bharathi PU College Mandya. Today I am going to introduce the new chapter, that is chapter number 13, probability. Before going to the chapter, let's have a brief explanation of the basics concept of the probability. Let's come to the experiment or a trial. Here I am taking tossing a coin is an example, okay? So what is experiment or trial? The definition of experiment or trial is calculating the chances of the happening of an event, okay? What is going to happen after calculating of an event, that is called the experiment or trial. The example is tossing a coin. Here I am going to toss a coin. So chances of happening are head or tail, because the coin has only two faces. So the probability of getting, the chances of happening, that is either head or tail. So what I am going to get after the event, that means after happening of the event, it will be either head or tail, okay? So what I am going to get after the experiment, that we used to call it as outcomes, okay? After tossing a coin, what are the outcomes I have got? Head or tail, okay? Here it has cleared what is outcome. After the experiment, what we have got as a result, that is called outcomes. Let's come to sample space. Here, what is sample space? Collection of all possible outcomes. Suppose I am doing an experiment, what are all the possible outcomes which are giving as a result? That will be as a collection, we used to call it as a sample space. Okay, that will be indicated in capital S, which is equal to head comma tail, because in this experiment I got only two outcomes. The collection of all outcomes right in a set form, we used to call it as a sample space. Next, come to the definition of probability. The formula is the probability of an experiment, which is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of all possible outcomes. So if I am have taken the probability of head, so favorable outcomes is head. How many head are exist here? Only one. And total number of outcomes? 1, 2. So the probability of head, after tossing a coin, I got 1/2. And the value of any probability of an event which lies between 0 and 1. Let's come to the topic. That is conditional probability, okay? Before I have taken a coin, I have tossed once only. Here an experiment, I have taken a coin, only single coin, I'm repeatedly tossing the same coin 3 times, okay? So after tossing single coin 3 times, I may get all the 3 tosses are head. Or first 2 are head, third one is tail. Or head, tail, head. Tail, head, head, or first head and next 2 are tail, or tail, head, tail, or first 2 are tail, the third one is head, either all the 3 trials are tail, okay? So here I have taken another event E, that will be an event at least 2 heads should be appear, okay? So I have written in the form of the event E, which is equal to how many 2 heads are appear? 1, 2, 3, 4. Here only one heads are there. So we should not consider, because it is exactly at least 2 heads should be there in that event. Okay. I have got out 4. I have written in the form of E. Let F be the event. First toss show the tail. Okay. So here wherever the tail is first. Tail is first. Here 2 and 3 and 4. So the event of the B will be the first toss should be tail. How many tails we won't consider, but the first toss should be tail, okay? Here we have 4, tail, head, head, tail, head, tail, 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 head, and all the 3 trials are tail, okay? Next, here I'm going to take the intersection of event E and F, okay? We have 2 events, event E and event F. Here the only common thing is tail, head, head, and tail, head, head, okay? So the intersection will be the common element tail, head, head. So the probability of an event over F, the event F, that is called a conditional probability. Here I am going to consider the probability of this over F that depends on what is the single thing, common thing between these two events and to the number of elementary events of the favorable to the event F, okay. So the probability of event over F, that is the conditional probability, which is equal to number of elementary event favorable to the E intersection F and divided by total number of elementary event favorable to F, okay. So the number of elementary events favorable to E intersection F will be in the form of number of A intersection F divided by number of elementary event favorable to F, that is number of elements N of F. So here N of S is total number of elementary events of a sample space. I have a sample space here, that is it has 8 elements. So number of S, that is number of total elements in sample space. So I am going to divide this total number of elements of a sample space to both numerator and denominator. So numerator is N of E intersection F divided by N of S whole divided by N of F divided by N of S, okay. So according to the definition of probability, number of favorable outcome, total number of possible outcomes. Here also, this is the favorable outcome, this is total number of outcomes. This is the favorable outcome, this is total number of outcomes. By the definition of probability, I will write probability of E intersection F divided by probability of F, that is the conditional probability E over F.